Nobody pull a hamstring.
Yeah,
warm your butt cheeks up. Warm up your butt cheeks.
Cut there.
Copy that.
There you go. Yeah, copy. Yeah.
I broke it.
Ew.
No, Brad, you had it. All right,
here we go.
The thing about time travel. I can't believe I made a whole movie with this thing on.
Yeah, does it look cool or doesn't feel cool, but if it looks cool, that's what matters.
Do you have any idea what's coursing through my veins right now?
Funyuns?
Yes.
Orange soda?
We are getting the whole team, aren't we?
A duck!
Good one.
You have to deal with here?
10 years of this.
Avengers!
Assemble.
Here we go. Nobody pull a hamstring. Warm up.
This movie is massive.
It was so much fun.
Insane.
This doesn't feel cool, but if it looks cool, that's what matters.
I think I'm a very lucky guy.
Keep on fighting! Keep on fighting!
It's an amazing, super emotional, beautiful thing.
It was really a joy.
And the rest is history.
It's indescribable to work with creative people, especially people who make movies. It is such a thrill. It's overwhelming when I think about it. And I keep saying to myself, I can't believe this is me. I can't believe I lucked out this way.
Let's give it up for Stanley, guys.
Lousy words they gave me to say.
Thank you so much. Yeah. You're a great director.
It's something you never forget.
And thank you for all of this, and I hope that I didn't set interviewing back a few decades. Okay. I'll see you later. Thank you.
Appreciate it. I remember every cameo I've done since the first one. And I think I'm a very lucky guy.
Being able to do this new version of Thor, it's hugely liberating and fun. We had a big sort of fat suit, which I think was sort of 60 or 70 pounds.
This little move.
Yeah, that's the shimmy.
It was the hottest I've ever been.
How does that feel?
Oh, I mean, amazing.
Looks like it's in the right.
And we had obviously the beard, the hair, and I had these things that go in the mouth to kind of plump out my cheeks a bit, which sort of had a little effect on the voice as well, but probably in a good way. It was a different Thor.
Hey, my name's Thor, 22 years old, live on Asgard, and I like sugar.
We're shooting a superhero film, and here's one of the most recognizable superheroes, but he's just turned into a new character. What Chris does with that character and how it just kind of has this shift, his excitement was really palpable.
He had been playing the character for a while and really wanted to find something new. He has such dexterity as a talent. He's incredibly funny. He has just really lovely energy.
Is he asleep?
No. I'm pretty sure he's dead.
We all made a bond that I think is really exceptional and rare. And we got to do really great stuff that the fans really loved. You know, you know that's kind of coming to an end. So it was always a little bittersweet, and it was always on everybody's mind. Like, you know, I'd be in a scene with Robert and I'd look over at him and we'd just be like, we did this, you know? And that was really moving at times.
Certainly was, you know, a lot of nostalgia, slight sort of melancholy. These people have become family, and we've shared some years of our life together now.
You anticipate it being an emotional experience, but then when they actually say, you know, Chris, you're wrapped, and it's done. It's like that graduation day. You know it's coming, but then when it hits, you can't prepare for it. It was more emotional than I expected.
This is the fight of our lives. And we're gonna win. Whatever it takes.
He's pretty good at that.
Right?
Peggy has a career. And she has a lot of self-respect, and she's pretty sick and tired of lots of men kind of not taking her seriously in the army and you know, playing around with her. I think Peggy relates to someone really fighting for what they believe in and really having to struggle all the time to prove themselves. And she, being the only woman in this environment, knows exactly what that feels like. It's not just the normal, everyday love story. There's something else.
In the same way that we love Steve because he exhibits some sort of determination and selflessness, it's the same thing that attracts her to him.
Steve learned a lot from Peggy Carter. If you go back and look at the first Avenger, that is the essential relationship that I think turned him into who he is today. It turned him into Captain America. Her sense of integrity, her call to action, are all qualities that have been ingrained in Steve and are his best qualities. And they come from example from Peggy. And so I think it was critical that her character embody those essential qualities, because he wouldn't be who he is without them.
I'm gonna need a rain check on that dance.
A week next Saturday at the Stork Club.
You got it.
8 o'clock on the dock. Don't you dare be late.
Avengers!
Assemble.
Here we go.
Nobody pull a hamstring. Warm up.
This movie is massive.
It was so much fun.
Insane. This doesn't feel cool, but if it looks cool, that's what matters.
I think I'm a very lucky guy.
Keep on fighting! Keep on
fighting! It's an amazing, super emotional, beautiful thing.
It was really a joy.
And the rest is history.
I actually think that in some weird, and it is a very emotional thing, but some weird twisted up, fateful way, this character who, you know, has searched her whole life for a purpose actually finds her purpose. And it's like this amazing, super emotional, beautiful thing.
You know what I've become.
I don't judge people on their worst mistakes.
Maybe you should.
You didn't.
I feel very fortunate. It's been an incredible gift as an actor to be able to come back to a character that's as complex as Natasha. I think there's kind of a lot to explore there, and that is so exciting.
My favorite moments are oftentimes at the premiere, because I get to see everybody all in one place.
Those times when you get to like be with each other and really understand the work that you've been doing.
It's emotional personally for all of us, and also for the movie. It's very personal.
I just love playing my character so much, and I think that she's so misunderstood that people are starting to understand her a little bit more.
I've had a few quiet moments with Downey. He's always just really been such a wonderful mentor in a lot of ways, and I've really kind of said to myself, don't forget this.
The whole process has been really celebratory.
You know, it's one that I just kind of still can't believe that it's happened.
There's a lot of pathos in these last two that I just don't think you see in superhero movies.
This is the one I'm most excited to see, this last one.
I haven't had a bad trip yet. I'm super grateful.
Some people move on, but not us. Not us.
That's incredibly emotional. And we're bringing to close a 6.5-year journey for us and a 10 to 11-year journey for some of the actors.
These characters have come to define major parts of their careers, and they're ubiquitous with these characters on a global level.
This has been in my mind, I think more than anything, it's just that journey from self-centeredness to making space for others, to making space for a relationship with Pepper, to having comic tragic things happen like with he and Cap.
Thank you, Tony. Will you keep that a little quiet? Didn't bring one for the whole team.
And then healing because we had to come together to fight for the greater good. There's something really profound about it.
You trust me? I do.
What I put upon my character, those very principles of family and value. You're talking about a superhero with zero superpowers, but it's a guy you don't want to mess with because the values of him are unflappable.
Whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes. He's just an everyman. He has a high skill set.
I don't know how you're gonna get us through all of that.
Don't worry.
She's got help.
It was really beautiful to feel this sort of Marvel sisterhood, you know, and we're all coming from so many different films that we all came together.
It's kind of like, I see what you do. I know your powers. Okay, show me what you got. And then we just clicked. And we were just like cheering each other on.
Everyone's just kind of taking their turns, moving around, trying to help each other out. It was so fun.
You share
exactly
this connection.
So there's a connection without ever having met. It's a really cool thing about the whole battle.
That day was insane. We were all in it together, and it felt electric. It was really, really cool.
You know, I normally don't watch playback on the monitor, but I wanted to see that reveal of all the women of Marvel, and I thought it was really powerful and really exhilarating, and I was thinking of all of the young girls in the audience who will probably feel really inspired by that in one way or another, so it was a really nice thing to be a part of.